pause for just a minute before we pray, because you know, as a pastor, sometimes you have to be a lot of places, and all at once sometimes. And it seems like sometimes nothing happens for a long time. Happy you're with us, sister. It seems like something doesn't happen for a long time, then it seems like something happens. It doesn't stop, you know. We've had in our church family and friends a tragic week, really. There's been so many people in the hospital, major surgeries. We almost lost Memo and Francis' oldest daughter the other night. The doctor didn't expect her to make it through the night. About 4 in the morning, she started coming through, and I know a lot of you are praying for her. And my heart was broken for them. They didn't think their daughter was going to make it. 17 years old. And we had a baby born this week. Richard and Alyssa had their son. Amen. Little Richard, he looked just like Harry, though. We didn't call him little Harry. You know, and then Alyssa went home and was in a lot of pain, and she went back to urgent care, and they sent her home with medicine. And 1:30 in the morning, that's why they're not here today. 1:30 in the morning, the ambulance had to come get her, and she had to have surgery. Alfonso and Misha, she's pregnant and she's been having a lot of pain, and ended up being had to take her appendix Friday night, right? Friday night. Grandma Rose was struggling 3 days. They tried to take her off of the ventilator. And, you know, your guys' prayers have really answered a lot. My wife doesn't normally like to go with me because she knows I take all day. I go to visit and I come home 8 hours, 10 hours later, you know. But there's just things that happen, you know. Sister Reba's surgery was major. She's still in the hospital. Yesterday she went with me. My wife went with me yesterday to the hospitals and visited several people. And we spent 8 hours together visiting people in the hospital. And today my wife's not with us. She woke up this morning and she couldn't hardly breathe. About 3 in the morning she was struggling to catch breath. And her headache was so bad she could hardly see it. She's struggling at home right now. I have my phone on in case I have to leave. So it's just been one of those weeks, you know. And we need to really, really be praying for people, families, and the struggles they're going through. I appeal to you today to pray for my wife. More than anything in the world, she loves being here. She loves this place. She loves you guys. She loves working with kids, as sick as she is sometimes, you know. And for her not to be here today, she's, you know, I'm worried about her. I shouldn't be here today. So keep these people in prayer. We have young people, you know, that are at more times in the hospital than I could ever imagine. Visiting your young son one day, you know, that was heartbreaking to me. It's just, we just need to love each other and just keep each other in prayer. Hold each other up. Amen. We're all struggling. And this is just illnesses we talked about and things of this nature, but there's other things going on in our lives that we need to be holding each other up for.
Yeah.
And life, it seems, walking through that valley of the shadow of death that Lewis talked about this morning, seems to be getting harder and harder, especially for young people today. So let's hold each other up, amen? Let's know who God is and know who we are in Christ. And let's exalt his name by the prayers being answered, amen? And the lives that we live because of it. And anyway, I didn't want to steal your thunder.
There's no competition.
Hold that. Just pray this morning. Or, really pray this morning. You know?
Her niece too.
Her niece too. Her knee is hurting all the way from her knee to the bottom of her foot. She's still going to work every day because she can't afford not to. And she's just struggling. So just pray for her. Probably so many others you guys are thinking of.
We got a few more up here. Kylia says to pray for Nisha's soul in Jesus' name. Sarah, please continue to pray for my friend Marvin. Release sin in Jesus' name. Thank God for Pastor Matt and others who helped pray for Nisha and her unborn child. She had surgery a few days ago and all is well. Please continue to pray for her and complete healing in Jesus' name. Please bless every married couple to come to you, God, and to serve you for eternity in Jesus' name. And pray for my son Tommy's return here in Jesus' name. Pray for Kathy and Nisha and Reba and others. Others with, I think, I probably read them out of order. I'm sure it's others with other problems going on. And Antoine says, please pray for our church family, bless you. For those who are sick and not here and going through hardship and trying to find somewhere to live or trying to find a stable job and whatever situation they're currently in. And I also want to end it with a praise. We've been praying for Antoine, and he's in a new place now, and he has a new job now, and God's just taking care of him. And he just knew it was going to happen, and we did too.
Can I say something?
Yeah.
Real quick. That's one thing my church family met, everything is, last 6 months has been really hard, And God really came through for me. I got a job, I got my training, we did last week. Everything set up for everyone to come over for dinner. We're gonna make a big old dinner, so little not that big, but we're gonna all fit.
You know, and I look at Antoine's situation, things were getting out of control for him, and I believe that God said, okay, and just a step back, and he allowed things to come on him. To draw Antoine back to him, and you know what, and he does it, and Antoine recognized it. He said, you know what, I did put God on the back burner, and so Antoine stepped it up, and he said, look, I'm going to serve you, God. I'm going to put you first. I'm going to trust in you, and I'm going to show my kids how much you mean to me and how much you love them, and so he stepped up and rededicated his life, And now look, God's just pouring out on him. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. He's going to take care of you. He's going to meet your needs. It's not always what we think it should be or what we would hope it would be, but we know he's going to take care of us. And those are promises. God will sustain us, and he will take care of us if you just let go of the worries and the anxieties and just seek him and his peace and trust. And that's when we lift all these prayers up, we got to know. God's going to answer them. It might not be what we would hope for, but God's got a bigger plan, and God is in control. God is in control, and we got to know. So let's lift these prayers up and all those mentioned, all those on our hearts. Alex.
Oh,
okay. He's just preparing to pray. So let's raise our hand and lift these up in prayer. Father, we thank you, Father. We thank you for your promises, Lord, that you will meet our needs, that you will sustain us. And you tell us to lift up our brothers and sisters. It helps us to have a more other-centered heart, Father. And so we just thank you, Father. We thank you that there's so much you try and teach us and show us and grow us, and we can't possibly grasp it all. But we need not try and grasp it all. We just need to seek you, Lord, to seek you and to seek your righteousness and know that you're going to take care of things, that you're going to meet our needs. Lord, we lift up all these hurting people, Lord, all of these mentioned, Lord. We lift up Kathy to you, Lord. We appeal to you, Lord, just restore her, heal her, Father. Let her feel your peace and your comfort right now, Lord. Take away her pain, Lord, and just let her feel your presence, Lord. Your warmth, your comfort, Lord. Let her feel you just holding her up, Lord. And Father, I just say the same prayer for all these people, Lord. me, so Lord, gosh, I'm gonna miss so many of them. Lord, Reba and Rosie and both Kathy's, Lord. You know the names. You know the names. We just read them, Lord, and Pastor Matt spoke them, and the prayers that are on our hearts, Lord. We just pray for all these people, Lord. We lift them all up to you, Lord. We pray, Father. We pray for the ones that are going through mental things, going through needing jobs, Lord, or whatever it is, Lord. We just pray that you would meet the need. We pray that you would heal these bodies, Lord, and strengthen and restore them, Lord. Draw them back to you, Lord. Not that they left you, Lord, but when people are hurting, they tend to focus on their pain, Lord. Help them to see you and to feel you and to know that you're there, holding them up, Lord. Put their minds back on you, Lord. Let them feel your spirit and your presence, Lord. Father, we just pray for healing. We pray for healing. We lay all these people before your altar, Lord, that you would just reach out and touch them all, Lord. Touch them. Heal them. Sustain them, Lord. And most important, Lord, that they would feel your spirit and draw closer to you, Lord. Father, I just pray for this body, Lord, and whatever the enemy is trying to throw our way, Lord, that we would just overcome it, Lord. We would just seek you and know that we're overcomers because you overcame, Lord. We just thank you, Lord, and we praise you. And it is in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
Amen.